I'm Loren Keim with Real Estate's Next Level Training. Today we're talking about creating some engaging videos to attract prospects. I'm going to share with you many different methods of both designing and using video in your real estate practice. How to really build your brand, to build your business, and how to set yourself apart from everybody else in your market. Some of what I show you today might seem a little corny on the surface, but be assured that everything I outline is designed to grow your real estate practice. Everything from home video tours to effective drone tours to informational videos, right down to video that's intended to make you stand out.
Video is the hottest ticket to engaging today's consumers. Whether it's used to build customer trust and loyalty, or to stand out as a local area expert, or simply to effectively market your property and generate more sales. Now, the video you're seeing on the screen is one that cost $40,000 to produce. Don't worry, you don't have to do that. You can do some really nice drone tours for $200 or $300, maybe $400. But this particular video was done for a house in Bel Air in California. It was a $33 million home, and yes, it did sell. But more importantly, when the agents put this video out there, so many people watched it, so many eyes were on it, that it attracted a number of customers to call that particular realtor, and that realtor picked up more than just the sale on this property. So let me ask you something. If you pick up several $10, $20, $30 million buyers, is it worth spending $40,000 on one video that attracts that kind of reaction? And I'm going to leave for you to decide. I'm going to start with some fun videos before we get down to drone tours and show you how people build brand recognition. The next video I'm going to show you is from an agent of Coldwell Banker that's in North Carolina that actually has gotten hundreds of thousands of views on this video. That's probably far enough for this particular video, but just showing you, this is a video that has absolutely nothing to do with real estate other than showing the sign and asking people to call her. But this video has been seen by hundreds of thousands of people because everyone shared it. And what that's led to is everyone in town knowing the name of one realtor. She has branded herself as the realtor who's on the internet, the realtor who's out there constantly. And she does short videos every day on the market and what's happening, and people follow her. And she has thousands of people following what she does. Has that been effective to build that brand for herself? I would say yes. You can do parody videos that work quite well. Now, of course, there are parody videos that don't work quite as well as also.
Do you want to sell your house now? Some have sold in just a day. You don't really like it anymore. Come out the door. You can move away.
Now, don't get me wrong, this particular realtor has done some great stuff, some great videos, and is a very successful realtor. I just thought that one that she did there was kind of corny. There's another version of it out by another realtor that I thought was pretty decent.
The signs outside and the agents are here. This is finally getting real. They're starting to schedule showings, and I don't know how I feel. My tears aren't falling, but they're swirling up inside. I gotta keep it in, swore I wouldn't cry. Just let them in, just let them see. This house is perfect, I always keep it clean. They're gonna feel like it's their own. So let them show. when it's all.
Now, she's done some pretty interesting stuff with her videos. I thought this worked out pretty well, as most of them go. And I'll do one other one just because I think most realtors will like part of this. This is actually more against Zillow.
Zillow, it's me. I was wondering if after all these years you'd send me leads. Did I pay for anything? They say reviews are supposed to boost you, but I ain't seen much boosting.
Now, what I'm saying with all of this is not necessarily that you have to do spoof videos, that you have to have that much fun with what you're doing. But the idea is that some of these things that have been done online attract so many eyes that you can create the household name for yourself with what you put out there if you can put something together. Now, let me go through some ideas on video. It's estimated that in 2015, 204.2 million people in the U.S. watched online video monthly. I don't have the 2016 statistics. And that might be on their cell phone, that might be, or digital device, it might be on their iPad, it might be on their television. But it represents 68.6% of all U.S. internet users. In other words, 4 out of 5 users are on the internet looking at video. And the amount of time online users spent watching online video grew almost 40% in only 2 years. 64% of all internet traffic globally is video consumption. So what does that mean? YouTube is crushing cable, according to Google. There are more people online watching YouTube right now at any point in the day, at any point in the night, than are watching ABC, NBC, and CBS combined. This is one from the Daily Mail. YouTube defeats television in the battle for viewers as it pulls in 1 billion unique visitors a month. That's absolutely astonishing. So how do we leverage that? How do we get people eyes on our stuff, get people to look at what we're trying to sell? A couple other things that are interesting. Video content generates on average 3 times as many monthly visitors as other content. That means that if you've got video on your websites, you're going to have more eyes on your website, more people checking out your website, and you're more likely to rank higher. Websites with video content enjoy 88% more time spent on pages by visitors. And having video content on pages can contribute to 157% increase in organic traffic from search engines. Product videos increase the likelihood of purchases by 85%. You know, you go to one site and you're looking for a grill and you see a front photo of it. And the next site has a front photo, a back photo, a side photo. And the next site has videos on how to use that grill, what to do with it. Same thing happens in real estate or any type of product that you're trying to sell. The more you see, the more you enjoy and engage those consumers, the more likely you are to get them to work with you. Some of the goals that we're going to have in using video in your real estate practice are, of course, marketing and selling your listings. That's critical. But we also want to get people to raise their hands and identify themselves as people who want to buy and sell real estate. So we want to attract buyers who want to buy now. We want to attract sellers who want to sell those houses now, and we want to engage future buyers and sellers with some content. In other words, develop a contact list that we can follow up with, and of course, we want to build our brand. Those are all critical components of using video in our marketing. Some of the types of real estate videos, and we're going to go through some examples of each, include doing a home tour, a visual tour, a property tour. That can be done with a drone. It can be done using a tour that has a story with some humor. It can be done in, we can also do marketing update videos. What's happening in the marketplace? You know, Century 21 puts those on regularly. Where are we in the marketplace? What's happening? We can do local information videos and what we call town tours, and I'll get into that in a couple of minutes. We can do educational videos and other content, and we can do creative or viral videos telling a story or adding some humor. And then we can also do ongoing video content or ongoing video programs, which we'll talk about in a little bit. So videos might be your most powerful tool. We talk about Google page ranking. you might not be able to get your site to outrank Zillow or Realtor.com or Century21.com. Keep in mind, you put in whatever town you're in, HoustonRealEstate.com or Houston Real Estate, you're going to have hundreds of thousands of sites show up, and you're probably on page 57 because you can't get enough content in yours to make yours show up higher than Zillow or Realtor.com or Century21.com. But a study showed that a video on YouTube is 53 times more likely to rank on the first page of Google search results than your website, because Google prioritizes video results. When you do a search, you notice some of those videos on the right-hand side. Those are pulled from YouTube. And the video connection in your video can link back to your site, helping your ranking as well. It might be a very powerful tool for you. And Google is rolling out something called transcriptions. They've done a soft rollout so far. That takes all the text of your video, all the speaking in your video, converts it to actual text and words, and attaches it to your video so that your video can be ranked. And all that content that you've got in your video can be found by Google. How might that affect your ranking online if you've got a lot of videos with a lot of content built in and other people don't? How would that affect it? Now, I want to start by talking about the standard, which is visual tours or home tours. Remember, we're doing video instead of just still photos and stitching them together if we can. So you have to show that it's video. That means have a ceiling fan running, have a tea kettle on the stove, have a fire going in the fireplace. Showcase the fact that it's video and not still photography. I think that's a critical component. And then with visual tours, leverage your seller's relationships. Once you get that video tour online, you want to share that with everybody that you know. You want to put it in your Facebook page, your Google Plus page, tweet it on your Twitter account, post it anywhere you possibly can, but also take that video and share it with your owner, the property owner, and let them know that we have no idea where a buyer's going to come from. So would you do me a favor, Mr. and Mrs. Seller? Will you share this on your Facebook page, tweet it on your Twitter account, and ask your friends and relatives to share it as well so we can get as many eyes on this as possible? And let me tell you something. If you ask them to put it out there, they will. And the more places that goes, it's not just advertising their house, it's advertising you. And how many of their friends and relatives are listed with Doggy Breath Realty, the ones with diarrhea of the mouth, who have not actually contacted their client in the last 90 days? And who are they going to list with when that house expires? The one they haven't heard from, or the one who did this great, fantastic video tour for their friend or relative? So get it out there. Now, when you're creating a video tour, you want to try and use a drone if possible, because you're going to get better images. We're going to talk a little bit about using a tripod and a slider, which creates motion. But we're going to talk right now about drone tours because it's the future. Now, you have to be careful of some of the legal issues, because you are not supposed to use a drone to do a video tour of a property unless you have a license to do so. We've already been served notice by the FAA. What that means is you have to get somebody licensed, or you have to find somebody who is licensed to do that for you. But you can create some stellar videos. And the drone that you see on the screen is not the kind you go and buy at Kmart or Walmart. If you see the bottom is the camera, it's a round thing and it's hanging off the drone. Why is that? Because you want a drone that, or you want a camera that is not fixed to the drone. That's hanging on something called a gimbal. The gimbal keeps that camera more level, more steady, so that when you're shooting video, it doesn't wobble when it's flying through the air. And that's a problem with a lot of those cheaper cameras that you buy, or cheaper drones that you buy. You won't actually get a good video because the entire there's a little bit of wind everywhere, and you're going to get a little bit of wobble to the drone. So you want the camera to stay steady no matter what you do. Now, let me show you some examples. This is a drone flying around a house. Some of the drones, by the way, are you can pre-program. You put it on your iPad, and instead of actually physically flying it, you program what it does. You might geolocate the house, and you tell the drone to fly a pattern around the house, keeping the wide-angle lens focused on the house to get a good picture. And you can do this around the second story, or you can do it higher to try and get the best pictures you can. I'm going to show you a couple of examples. Now, this is unfortunately slow because of my computer, but this is lifting off from the ground. This is using the iPad app to carefully circle the house very nicely. And then we're doing what's called a flyover, where we actually fly over the house. It gives a nice image of the property and the surroundings. And obviously, this is a whole lot better than just a still photo. And by the way, you can use some of these shots and save them as JPEGs to add to your listings, make it look a little bit better. Let me see if I have another example here. This was done by one of our Century 21 agents. Now you notice he slows down at some points. This is a pan across the front. And he did a nice fly into the house. Now there's a brief example of what can be done with a drone. He did a nice shot around the outside of the house. Then he actually flew over the neighborhood into the house to show you the neighborhood and actually take you inside. And then he's taking shots inside with a wide-angle lens. Very nicely done. Next one's done by a friend of mine, Steve Leshak, who does great work. And this is on a horse farm. He's showing an aerial tour. Now, this is done a bit higher than the last one, where we're actually showing it from the air because we're trying to show you the view and we're trying to show you the surrounding land. And it does a pretty nice job of that. And then he has a flight coming up to it. This is a flyover coming low and then coming up. Now, you can't do this with the drones that you buy at Walmart because they don't have too many of them are fixed. You need something that hangs on that gimbal to actually make it work. And again, you need somebody who knows what they're doing that's experienced to put something like this together. Now, you can also take a home tour and you can try and make it viral as well by adding something funny to it rather than just professional. Here's an example.
I was working when the call came in. It was my cellars.
Century 21 Commonwealth, this is Lefebvre. Okay, settle down. Stay right where you are. I'm on my way.
There had been a robbery, and they made the logical call to me, their realtor. A nationally recognized community in one of the most desirable subdivisions in the town. It just didn't add up. With the K-8 schools just steps away, the public wanted answers fast.
Oh, thank God you're here.
No problem. I came as soon as I got the call, Dave.
It was steaks. Omaha's. Tender, juicy, and gone. Somewhere in this 2,200 square foot, four-bedroom, two-and-a-half-bath, hip-roof colonial, there was a beef thief. And it was my job to sniff them out. We dusted for prints on the newly finished southern pine floors in the custom country kitchen. The fireplace family room offered hardwood floors and a cozy atmosphere. But no clues. Nothing but chair rail molding and a generous walkout bay window in the dining room. The hardwood floors in the formal living room gave us our first break in the case. Exhibit A. The rubber chicken. Heading upstairs, we checked out the updated full bath. Its ceramic tile floors and Corian counter vanity. All four bedrooms were generous in size and offered hardwood floors and ceiling fans. But again, no clues. As soon as we entered the master suite, my gut told me this case was about to break wide open.
Now that's a well-executed home tour where they've actually outlined everything about the house and still got your interest and still was able to get tens of thousands of eyes on this house. Did that actually sell the house making a video like this? Maybe not. But it did it set that agent apart enough that other people may have called him to list their properties. I think that's a good possibility. Now you can also try to be funny and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't work, as in this example.
Do you like real estate and baby goats? I do. I'm top producing agent, Spencer Fritz.
I thought you were in the third role.
Now don't get me wrong, that was funny, and everything he does in this video is quite entertaining. Will that attract more people to list with you? I don't know, but it does get a lot of eyes on what you're doing. There are lots of different methods people use to try and attract attention. For example, One agent uses Corgi Realtor Presents and actually follows her dog through the house as the dog acts like the realtor. And then another agent I'll show you in a minute. Let's look at one more example of a home tour. Again, this one was attempting to be funny and try and show the property in a humorous light.
Hi, I'm Riley LePage, and I'm standing in what could very well be your next condo. It has a washroom, a balcony. It has not one, but two bedrooms. A kitchen. And a freshly renovated living room, just for you. But don't forget the amenities, like a pool.
Did you know that doing the breath stroke can burn up to 0.36 calories per stroke? That's almost as many calories that you wear.
Hitting balls in this terrific tennis court. And if that's not enough, you could
lift things up and put them down.
Okay, again, maybe not the best, most professional video looking at a property. However, it has gotten tens of thousands of hits, and everybody in town knows this particular realtor. So, is it effective? Maybe. It does get somebody known, but you have to put in some professionalism, maybe some humor, but also showcase the property. In addition to doing tours of homes, there are lots of other things you can do with video. As Century 21 does, market update videos, you can do the same thing. Personally branded updates on your market made by you, the local industry expert for the current real estate market. And that can lead to business, it can lead to press and other benefits. And they don't have to be long, they can just be talking about what's happening in the marketplace. You can also do something called town tours or local information. And that helps you to rank higher on Google, and I'm going to show you some examples of that. There are many top agents around the country that are making short video tours of each area in their marketplace because they rank so high on Google. People searching for Catasauqua, Pennsylvania, or Little Rock, Arkansas, are going to find some of the videos showing up on that first page of Google if those videos get some attention. So in major metropolitan areas and towns or boroughs, you can stand in front of something iconic in that neighborhood or that area. You can talk about what makes that neighborhood or that small town great. And these videos can be a minute or two or three long. And you can even use what's called B-roll photos or video of the area in the background to stitch it together while you're talking about the area. Some agents have gone so far to do a video of each neighborhood, neighborhood by neighborhood in their particular communities. Now here's an example of an agent who did something that was so successful that the competition had to respond. And this is just a quick video of a town.
Hi, Jonathan Carbuti here with Carbuti & Company Realtors, and welcome to our town tour of Branford. What's nice about Branford is it's a bedroom community for New Haven. You're close to I-95. You're about 10 to 15 minutes from New Haven, and you're probably about another hour from New York City. You wouldn't normally think of Branford being along the shoreline as a commuter town, but we actually have a newer train station here that runs right into New York City, and then you connect right with the Metro North line, and an hour and 10 minutes, you're in New York City Grand Central Station. Right now we're in the center of Branford. What's cool about here is that you have the town green that's right in front of Town Hall. You have all these coffee shops.
Now we cut this video to show you the end of it.
Just want to thank everyone for joining us here for our Branford town tour. And if you're interested in more information about this beautiful town or you'd like to tour some homes, just give us a call. Thanks for watching.
Now this video was so successful, it did so well, that the competition went out and hired a camera crew to try and come up with a competing piece. Now they may have gone a bit overboard in this video.
Time to set sail and explore the beautiful town of Branford, Connecticut. Perfectly settled along the Connecticut shoreline.
And again, we clip
After
the end.
After taking a peek at a day around town, you should note, being a Branford resident makes it hard not to boast.
Now, that was a bit of overkill. Beautiful video, but you need to take it to that level. Probably not. Your goal is to showcase your area and at the same time brand yourself and hopefully rank higher on Google and YouTube, where people can actually find something about you, about your town, and see your information. That's what we're really looking for. Now, there are companies and agents that have done this all over the country and done short videos on Albany Park, Bucktown, Gold Coast, Hyde Park, every neighborhood in a particular area. And as an example, some of the hits on some of these neighborhood videos, Avondale, 93,000 views. How many of you would like to see 93,000 views of anything you put online? 22,000 views of Bucktown on the right-hand side, the middle of the page, 23,500 views on Gold Coast, and so on. Tens of thousands of views of some of these areas. And people are not just seeing information about the area. They're seeing your message attached to it, and they're seeing you as the neighborhood specialist, as the area specialist, as the person who can help them. Powerful, powerful tool. You can also do what we call educational videos. Try and figure out what questions were asked the most often. Questions for first-time homebuyers. Well, what special loans are available? If you're selling a home, will the realtor buy it? You can create a video around that subject, 3 or 4 minutes, and post that online and link it back and put that into some of your email campaigns and share it on Facebook, and you're going to attract some attention. Each audience that you deal with has different questions, and a video can address each of those. Not only does the video address the question, because you can write stuff on your page, can't you? You can write stuff on Facebook. But the reality is the video humanizes you and introduces you to that couple or that person who's looking for a property and makes you the person that they want to deal with because they see you as a person, not just some words on a screen. Create these educational videos. How to get pre-approved for a loan before you buy a house in Houston. Try and bring it down to your local level if you can. And you can take some of these informational videos and you can create a series of them. And when you're doing follow-up campaigns and you're sending out those follow-up emails that you should be sending out to your customers, anyone who contacts you, instead of simply sending out something that has some text in your email, why don't you embed a video in every email that goes back? And one of them might talk about shopping for a home. The next one might talk about pre-qualifying for a loan and writing an offer and the home inspection process and what goes into a settlement. Create those short videos. I know this seems like a lot of work and it can overwhelm people, but the reality is if you put this together in a cohesive system, you're going to be very pleased with the results over time because people are going to feel like they know you before they ever meet you. And you're taking this to the next level, to another stage above what everybody else sends out that looks like simple emails that are part of a system.
Hey everyone, it's Jessica Ripple here in Wilmington, North Carolina. And today I just wanted to talk briefly about real estate commissions. When you list your property with a real estate agent, as you all know, you have to pay a commission. That's how we get paid.
Now, Jennifer is the same person who did the video at the beginning of our presentation. She's put together a series of these short videos, and she does it from her car. I'd probably do it in my office or someplace else. But she actually goes through talking about each different subject that you might have interest in real estate. She sends it out to everybody. She posts it online, and lots of people follow her. You can also do targeted educational videos. How to buy a house with no money down or little down payment. What are veterans' mortgage benefits and how do we get them and how do we use them? How do you find foreclosures? Where are they in your marketplace? What's your home worth? One that we've been having a lot of fun with lately is should you sell your house in a divorce? What should you do? Create a short video about that. And you can put that out online, you can share it, you can send it to people, and you're going to get traction because some people are going to see it. You're going to actually get some buyers and sellers are going to call you. And by the way, when you create these targeted educational videos, you can even pay Google and YouTube to put the first 5 seconds of your video in front of anybody else's video that's in your zip codes. You pay them to do that for a few pennies. Just like you see any other video you go to, you see a little clip, a little ad in the beginning. You can create your video as an ad to others and have them link back to your video to find out more information. Again, very inexpensive way of marketing yourself. And with any targeted educational video, there should always be a call to action at the end of each video so the consumer can find you or can identify themselves, can raise their hand and say, I'm in the market to buy or sell a property now or in the near future. That's what we're looking to do. You can also create episodes, ongoing video programs. Episodic content may evolve like a television series with an audience growing with expected content. Some of the other ones that realtors have had success doing is videos on local schools and school districts, which again, Google may bring up in a search. If you're searching in the Parkland School District and you're trying to find something out about the Parkland School District and there's a video on Google about it, is it more likely to show up? And is it more likely that a consumer will see that and then see your message as well? How about you go out and do a couple of short videos, 2-minute videos on the best restaurants to frequent in your area? Go into the restaurant and ask them if they would mind, or call ahead, of course. Ask them if they'd mind if you videotape the restaurant because you're doing a short series on YouTube about great restaurants in the area. They'll be thrilled. And by the way, once you post that, that restaurant is going to share it everywhere as well. They're going to put it on their Facebook page. And again, you're connecting with their customer base with your message. You can do the same thing with for commercial real estate, where you might go out and look at different local businesses and do an interview series with local business people. And again, they're going to share that, and that is going to bring people back to your contact information. So if I want to shoot a video, what do I need? Well, I need an HD video camera. Yes, you can do it with your iPhone or your Droid. It's not going to look very good. It's not going to come out right, but you can start with that. I would go out and buy a $250 HD video camera, not a real expensive one, just a decent one. You're also probably going to use either a shotgun microphone or a wireless microphone, and I'll explain why in a couple of minutes. You need a tripod. I'll get to that in a minute. And you can also add maybe a slider, which I'll explain, and maybe a green screen to try and set this up. So let's go through some of this. Why do you need a tripod? Well, how many of you can hold a video camera perfectly straight when you're filming a house? Well, some of you are lying, because the truth is you can't. What happens is when you're holding that video camera, you're breathing. And just you breathing moves the camera up and down. You also have a pulse in your thumbs. And that pulse will register on that camera so that when you're playing it back, there's motion with the camera. When you put it on a tripod, it stays perfectly straight. So please, please, please use a tripod. They're $25 at Target. Go pick one up. Some of the other equipment you might want to use is a shotgun mic or a lavalier mic. Now, the onboard microphone that most people try to use will often not work to try and videotape what you want to video unless you're just doing the house and you're recording the sound separately. If you're standing in front of it, if you're talking to the camera, it's not going to be effective, and I'll show you some examples. A shotgun mic is something that directs the sound from a particular point and brings it back. A lavalier mic is something you're going to attach to your lapel, and it's going to hopefully go right into the camera. Now, here's an example of a camera microphone versus a lavalier. The first one I'm going to play is the announcer talking just using the onboard microphone.
What's your favorite part of the job? Does it take you a long time to do them?
No, just drain the oil, pull the plug, put the filter in, the air filter, make sure the plug's tight, put the oil in.
Now you hear a lot of noise in the background, and it's really hard to hear the person you're interviewing. Very hard to hear the person you're interviewing. Listen to this with a lavalier mic, and listen to this guy's voice once we have a lapel mic on him, or a lavalier mic on him.
What's your favorite part of the job?
My favorite part of the job is doing the oil changes. I like them.
Does it take you a long time to do them?
Nah. Just drain the oil, pull the plug, put the filter in, the air filter, make sure the plug's tight, put the oil in, and that's it.
Now, isn't that a lot better? If you're standing in front of a property trying to talk, or standing in an area downtown trying to talk, you're not going to get that sound from your camera. Unfortunately, lavalier mics are a little pricey, but it is something you may want to invest in if you're going to be talking to the camera. Another type of piece of equipment is called a dolly track. The top one on the left is one that's manually done. Actually, they're both manual in this particular example. We also have automatic ones. This will move a lot like a drone and actually create motion and show motion in your video without you having to work very hard at it. It does some creative things. Let me show you an example. This is an automatic one, and it's videotaping across. Now, you can do the same thing with a drone, by the way. The other thing you're able to do with these is tip them up so that not just going panning across rooms, but you can also tip them up so you can get the same effect as a drone. Here's one tipping up. We're using that on top of a tripod. Very effective tool in addition to using a tripod. Now there's one other thing I'm going to show you here real quick. When you're editing video, you can shoot the video in whatever speed the video is shooting in, and then you can speed it up or slow it down depending on what you want to do with it. This is all done in the video editing software. But you can speed up or slow down video to create an effect. I'm going to try and show you one more example by the same person that we used earlier. And she does the same thing with speeding up and slowing down.
I hope that we sell it by Saturday.
Now what she's doing here is videotaping this twice. She has the camera set up on a tripod. The first version she does, she's sitting there by herself. The second version that she overlays this on top of is the people walking back and forth, and you can see the motion of the people walking back and forth. This is simply the same spot with the same camera running, and they've overlaid one video over the other to be able to show the motion in the background.
I thought the open houses would be what did the trick, but 2 weeks without an offer, oh, I hope it happens quick.
Again, an effective use of speeding something up and slowing it down. Now you can use any video editing software and simply plug into the video editing software the different clips you shoot, whether you're doing Movie Maker on Windows or whether you're doing iMovie on a Mac machine, or if you get more sophisticated software like Final Cut or Adobe Premiere. You take those video clips or the still photos and you plug them in and you create what's called a timeline. That's what you're seeing on the right-hand side. The timeline is the order you put it in, and then you can even add an audio file underneath it and put it all together, two audio files, one where you're talking and one with some music. And then what you'll see on the screen is a little YouTube button and a little Facebook button. What that allows you to do is share that to YouTube or to Facebook and get it out onto the web so that you can put it, you can share it with everybody that you know, and then embed that link in everything that you're sending out to clients. You can do direct marketing through online video as well. Like I said, YouTube has ads on other video. If you're watching anything on YouTube, you're probably seeing a 5-second clip before the show that you're trying to watch or whatever you're trying to see. Those people pay for those 5-second clips. And you can actually buy that time by either buying keywords like Houston real estate, or you can buy keywords and only have it impact those people who are coming from an IP address in a certain zip code. So you can have 18102, 18103, 18104, 18105 as your zip codes, and you can have your message go out to those people in those areas that have also searched for real estate. You can post these videos on Facebook. You can even do some Facebook live streaming.
Let me give you a couple of final thoughts on using video in your personal real estate practice. If you love the idea of doing neighborhood tours, but you can't figure out what to say, you're not alone. Writing a few sentences or paragraphs sends many of us into psychological paralysis. Did you know that there are plenty of starving community writers right in your local area? Community writers will often put together a script for a 3 to 5 minute video on the area for less than $100. Or you can check out the local colleges and find an intern to write them. Or you can check out the website Fiverr, where you'll find lots of great writers who will do something for you at minimal cost. My other final thought is that good intentions alone won't get those videos produced. Map out a plan of what you want to accomplish with each video, lay out storyboards for each piece, and get them done. You will create business.
And I'll end with one last video that you can watch to your heart's content.
I say I'm too late.
So many contracts on my plate. We're gonna miss a closing day. Miss a closing day. We got trouble with the loan, and clients blowing up my phone, and my kids are home alone. Oh no, kids are home alone. But I keep going, showing after showing, to keep this business growing. I'll be fine, I just hope I don't lose my mind. Cause the lender's gonna fake, 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 fake. Buyer's gonna flake, 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 flake. I just wanna take, 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 take. One day off, one day off. A doggy door, climb the fence. Oh no, I don't wanna climb the fence. These buyers can't make up their minds. Don't wanna show it one more time. That is unless they're gonna buy. Mm-hmm. And I know they're gonna buy. So I keep going, closing after closing. Keep this business growing. I'll be fine, I just don't wanna lose my mind.
I need a break.